Hey, do you want to win every single arena battle? If the answer is yes, then keep watching as I will tell you how you can win almost every single arena battle with this build. This is Rara Likes Games, and today I present to you a build that will help you win arena fights every single time. Now, this build uses the Great Holy Staff, so you can get the most rewards from every single arena victory. Now, unlike the normal healer builds, where you are just a bystander and your team is fighting, in this build, you can actually contribute and control the flow of the entire fight by yourself. Now, for armor, for your chest piece, you would be using the Robe of Purity or the Fiend's Robe, whichever one you can afford. For your helmet, any cloth helmet will do, as the ability you would be using for this build, Force Field, is available on all cloth helmets. For shoes, I went with Cleric shoes, and for cape, I chose Lyndhurst cape, as you would be running out of mana quite often. Now, food and potions aren't really necessary in an arena battle, but if you want, you can go with omelette for food and go with resistance potions for when you get in a sticky situation. Now, for your abilities, for your Q, you would want to use Holy Flash, which in recent update has been changed from the lingering effect on the ground where it used to heal based on the number of allies hit. It now is a ground targeted AoE heal, which heals a large amount regardless of how many people it hits. For your W, you would want to go with Holy Beam in case one of your allies get focused down and you need to bail them out. Now, your E ability with Great Holy Staff is called Holy Explosion. It heals your allies in a circle around you. It heals every 0.5 seconds and increases their resistance for the next 3 seconds. This ability also knocks back your enemy, so you can also use it to disengage a fight. Now, for armor, if you went with Robe of Purity, you should use Energy Emission. It creates an aura around you that would knock back your enemies far away. And if you choose Fiend's Robe, you should choose Fear Aura, which would fear the enemy away. For passive on all of your armor pieces, go with Aggression to boost your healing cast. Now, for helmet, regardless of which cloth helmet you went with, choose the ability Force Field, which would knock the enemy away from you. Now, for your cleric sandals, choose the ability Blink, as it would allow you to reposition during fights and even blink away if you are getting focused on. Now, for those of you who don't know, unlike arena in other games where it is a fight between two teams, in Albion Online, the arena plays out more like a capture the point, in which you have 3 points that you must capture to win the game. Now, you might have noticed that this build has a lot of knockbacks in it. This is because, unlike normal healer builds, where you stand back and just heal your allies, with this build, you will be fighting alongside your allies and using your knockbacks to knock the enemies out of the capture points so that your team can capture it. And by this way, you will be maintaining the flow of your and ensuring that your team has priority on all the capture points. Now, as for how to do this, you would be using your Q to heal all of your allies, and you would use your W to bail out your allies who might have taken too much damage by overextending. As for your E, you should use it almost as soon as it comes off cooldown, as you can get great value just from the resistances you get from it, and you can also use it to knock out the enemies from the capture points. Or you can also use your E or your Force Field when too many enemies are piling on top of one of your allies, so you can disengage for them. And when Use your armor abilities to knock out or fear away your enemies out of capture points and making it hard for them to get back in. Now you should use your blink to reposition yourself so you can get a better angle, or you can run away when you get focused down by the enemy. As the blink is instantaneous, it will allow you to disengage any engage that the enemy might have for you. Now if you enjoyed this video and liked the build, please consider liking and subscribing, and thanks for watching.